I've custom built this Sprit pole for code zero. We've got a 1.5-inch stainless tube here that is thick wall, 120 thousandths, and that slides nicely inside 1.75-inch tube, also 120 thousandths wall. And I've welded some 3/8 bolts onto the bottom, and that's going to drop into this teak block I made up here, and I have some reinforcing underneath the bow, so we're going to bolt all that together, and it's at a slight angle so that it ends up close to the center line when the pole's extended. Pole in its extended position is 20 inches ahead of the bow, and then there's a pin here so that you can retract it, and it can be stowed like that, retracted. The bobstay is going to attach to this 3/8 U-bolt. I couldn't find any U-bolts long enough, so I welded extensions onto them here. The reason I needed such a long U-bolt was because the Triton has a reinforcement beam here in the bow, and a lot of boats don't have that. Got the bobstay attached now to the Sprit pole, and that's a 1/4-inch stainless wire with a pelican hook on each end. So it can be released, and then this pin pulled and the pole retracted. Now here's the code zero furled up and ready to hoist. It's got a Profurl NEX 0.9 furler on it with a continuous spliced loop line, and there's a block on the end, and this is the upper swivel. Hoisted on the spinnaker halyard. Okay, the line comes off of the drum and goes through these Harken Fairleads. Another one here. The final Fairlead has a double cam cleat here, so that can be locked off there. And then when it's time to furl, we'll pull on one so that the sun cover rolls up on the outside. The elastic strap here provides enough tension to keep the line tight, and the block reduces the friction of it when you're furling.